We talked into the night. The kind of talk that seemed important until you discover girls.
All right. Mickey's a mouse. Donald's a duck. Pluto's a dog. What's Goofy? If I can only have one food for the rest of my life, that's easy. Pez. Cherry flavor Pez. No question about it.
Goofy's a dog. He's definitely a dog.
I knew the $64,000 question was fixed. There's no way anybody can know that much about opera. He can't be a dog. He wears a hat and drives a car. Wagon Train's a really cool show, but did you ever notice that they never get anywhere? They just keep wagon training.
God, that's weird. What the hell is Goofy?
Lord of Omens, give me sight beyond sight.
Greetings, Starfighter. You have been recruited by the Star League to defend the frontier against Zur and the Kodan Armada. Get ready? Prepare for blast off.
Hey, Doc, we better back up. We don't have enough road to get up to 88.
Roads? Well, we're going. We don't need roads.
Remember, no matter where you go, there you are.
This is 80's Reboot Overdrive Podcast.
We were dancing just like Swayze when Jennifer Grey had a nose. Oh, how I miss the 80's, but I'm too
Oh my god, that is like so dated.
This is 80's Reboot Overdrive, and I am Dave. Online I have got 80's Outerverse Scott.
Hi everybody, it's good to be back again.
It is definitely good to be talking again on a podcast. I wouldn't say a vacation, but we've just had, between technical issues and me having pneumonia, just haven't had the opportunity to really talk. So it's great to be back online again and be able to do a podcast. What we're doing today is Scott and I have decided that we're going to continue our conversation where we started to go through our 80s icons for Stand By Me. In this case, we want to tackle the subject of Jerry O'Connell. And now I think a lot of people, if they pull up this episode, and they're going to go, okay, Jerry O'Connell, 80s, I don't think there's a lot there. And the reason why we wanted to talk about Jerry is because he was definitely significant in the movie that we're talking about, Stand By Me. I mean, you can't think of Stand By Me without thinking Vern. You know, the guy who thought to bring the comb.
Yeah,
you know, I mean, you've got to definitely give the guy some due respect, you know, for his contribution to that movie, if only in the 80s for that movie. But you know, as we do at the beginning of these 80s icon shows, what we do is we go through the filmography in the 1980s for Jerry, which isn't going to take very long here. In 86, he did Stand By Me, which appears to be his first movie. 86, he did a TV movie called The Kingdom Chums, Little David's Adventure. 87, TV movie again, The Room Upstairs. 1988, The Equalizer. 1988, uncredited, he was in Police Academy 5, Assignment Miami Beach, which I think I brought that one up before in the past because I had this thing for Janet Jones. Different topic. We're talking about Jerry. 1988, TV movie, Ollie Hop Noodles, Haven of Bliss. That's a good name. 1989, Charles in Charge. So that's what he, that was what he was in the 80s. And, you know, and when I think Jerry O'Connell, you know, I'm thinking like, you know, his latter stuff, you know, and I'm thinking Jerry Maguire, Can't Hardly Wait, Trip McNeely. You know, I loved him in Can't Hardly Wait. But, you know, having to at least talk a little bit about the 80s, I think both Scott and I really just wanted to geek out about Stand By Me. Is that right?
Yeah, I gotta agree. I mean, Stand By Me, I can't speak highly enough of the overall movie and the book, and Stephen King's writing of the book. I think the writing is just amazing, and how he brought all four of those main characters to life, and gave them such unique characters, values and things about them. And Vern has definitely got some strong character. I mean, I rewatched it just recently, and I was still totally enthralled by it. I loved every minute of it. And one of the things that caught my attention was towards the end of the movie, as they're, you know, they finished up their quest to find the body, and they're on their way home, and they're splitting off into their own little thing. And as Vern walks away from the group, he looks down and he sees a penny, and he's so simple. You know, he's just enjoying the little simple things in life. Oh, look, a penny. And he walks away. I mean, it was just so, I don't know why that little moment caught my attention, but I thought it was so cool that, you know, that's how Vern was. He was just very entertained by the simplest things. And he was just a great little comic relief in that movie, I think, too. Cause there were some very serious things going on with, you know, Corey Feldman's character. There's a lot of serious things going on with River Phoenix's character. And of course, Will Wheaton's character was very serious, but I think they, you know, the way Stephen King wrote in Vern to kind of take the edge off of things sometimes, I think that was great. And Jerry O'Connell played a great role, played that role very well.
Yeah. He's so completely believable as that simple natured character that everybody just enjoyed picking on.
Oh yeah. You love them at the same time, you know. They like picking on them a little bit and give them a little, you know, a little bit of ribbing here and there, and but they still love to have them as part of their gang, as they referred to themselves later on in the movie. So
no, I mean, I'm not picking on him for being chubby. But do you see him as the Goonies equivalent of Chunk?
Maybe some similarities there, but you know, I think his at that age, you know, your body's going through a lot of changes, and you can tell that later on in life he looks completely different.
Oh yeah,
you would hardly I have a hard time recognizing him as Vern in some of his more recent stuff. It's hard to see him as that.
And that's why I precursored that with the it's not the chubby thing. It was just the simple natured character is what I was getting at.
Yeah, definitely. I like the simple side of him, of being entertained by the simple things and being, I think that's, you know, that's the way Stephen King wrote the character.
Right.
And Jerry definitely did a good job of portraying it that way. So.
Yeah, just, you know, to be the guy that, you know, I mean, I'm really, you know, my whole moment is I'm bringing a comb along. That way, when we're famous, you know, then, you know, we'll be able to fix our hair, you know, for the reporters.
Yeah.
It's like, just to think that way. Yeah. It's like, and Jerry made that believable. You know, you were like, okay, this is this guy's life, and that's how he's wired. I'm like, I wouldn't think that way. You know, I would be the, you know, try to remember to get all the different supplies and, you know, I'm going to go on this long journey or whatever, and, you know, I don't know if I'm the guy that's going to remember the gun, but, you know, I'm, you know, definitely the guy that's going to be like, all right, well, I've got to make sure I've got, like, my, you know, sleeping bag, and you know, I've got, you know, a change of shirts or something, like, I don't know, you know, that's, but I'm not the guy that's going to go, oh, let me make sure I get that comb.
You know, it's kind of funny that he might, his character might have been like the most well-adjusted character of the four, if you really think about it, because like Will Wheaton's character definitely was dealing with his dad preferring his older brother with the football career and all that,
right?
But then, you know, dying at a young age, and so Gordy was never really living up to his older brother's standards. And then you've got River Phoenix's character, who is just kind of, you know, he's trying to battle the battle his namesake,
right?
I guess. And and then you have Corey Feldman's character, who is, you know, dealing with his dad issues, but they really never delve into
like Vern's, yeah, like Vern's
family backstory. So, you know, as simple as some of the things that he enjoyed, it might be because he didn't have to deal with the adversity that some of the other characters had to deal with. So it made it, it made him a lovable character, because he was just there to have a good time and experience life, you know?
Yeah, I think, yeah, just being the character that's keeping it simple.
Right. So
and that's what it, yeah, that's what Jerry portrayed. You know, completely believable in that, and, you know, just the guy that's on the adventure for just the adventure, and not, you know, there's not like a, they didn't give him something that he had to get around mentally.
Right.
Yeah. The other stuff that he did in the 80s, I'm pretty sure that neither of us really caught any of those.
Yeah, I'm going to have to say I did not really catch anything. I do remember that the show, the TV series My Secret Identity, coming on in the late 80s. But I was, in the late 80s, I was really starting to get out of the house more often and hang out with friends, and we really didn't watch as much TV or movies at the time, in the late 80s. You know, it was more about music for me at that point. So I do remember it coming on TV, though. So, and he was in quite a few episodes.
Yeah, that was 1988 to 91, and I did not bring that one up, but
yeah. That one started in 88, so, you know, he was in a few. A lot, actually. Just 72 episodes that he was in. So he obviously is probably one of the main characters in that one.
He gets top billing when you look at the IMDb page.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Very cool.
Actually, yeah. The top four people, 72 episodes. So that's probably how many episodes were in that show.
Right.
And it's described as the adventures of a superpowered teen and his scientist friend.
Huh.
So, yeah, I actually did not watch that at all.
Yeah. And then, you know, he was in a couple other TV shows and spots here and there. But he really didn't come in onto the scene until, like, the 90s. And that's when, you know, like you said before, Jerry Maguire, yeah, Joe's Apartment. I remember that one. Scream 2, Can't Hardly Wait. There's a lot of, I mean, he's in like quite a few things after that up in the 90s and 2000s.
Oh my God, so, I loved him in Can't Hardly Wait. There was this scene where he's talking about, you know, you got to make sure you wear your, wear sandals in the showers, man. You know, he's talking about going to college. Trip McNeely, man.
Yeah.
The Trip McNeely.
So. Yeah, and then he was in Sliders, which was a really cool concept TV show.
Right, right.
So, anyway. I wish I had more to, you know, and I wish I had more material in the 80s to really talk about with Jerry. But he's still become a great actor, and he's done a lot of great stuff since then. So we can't, you know, got to give him credit for that.
Yeah, and I mean, as I was stating, yeah, the reason why we're doing the 80s icon for Jerry O'Connell is really his contribution into the movie Stand By Me.
Yeah, and it's, I mean, it's one of the most most powerful movies of the 80s. I mean, it's definitely one of my favorites it falls into my top 10 as far as best 80s movies, for sure.
It'd be tough to imagine that movie without Vern.
Oh, yeah. No, you can't have it without Vern.
I mean, I think, you know, he created this lovable, fun moment of it where it wasn't so heavy.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And that's what that movie needed. It needed, you know, it needed the comedic relief.
Yep, for sure.
And I think the others had some portion of that. They were able to contribute some of that, you know, where you had Will Wheaton telling stories, you know, that were, you know, lard ass and all that stuff. You know,
this is great. I love that. That story is awesome.
And so, you know, you had those kind of elements that kind of were intermixed, but Vern was always like that. You know, everything was kind of like, wow, I can't believe he, you know, that's the way he thinks. You know, and it's a simple character, and that's what's lovable about him. And I think, you know, as we stated, Jerry pulled that off very well. You know, for his first acting credit, even, you know, I got to give him, you know, mad props for that.
One of my favorite lines is that when he, after Gordy gets done telling the story, Vern asks the question, "What I'm wondering is how much did it cost Lardass to get into the pie eating contest?" like you're so far out there, you know, you didn't see that one coming. So it's good stuff.
I don't remember. You said you watched it recently, but, you know, at the end they talk about the, you know, what each character became.
Yeah.
What was Vern's?
Vern married right out of high school, had 4 children, ended up being a forklift driver.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. For a local, you know, right there in, well, what's the name of the town? Maine.
Oh, the one that,
where
Stephen King always writes about.
Yeah. I want to say Bangor, but that's not it. Drawing a blank now. Okay, Stephen King fans, do not harass me about that.
All right. Well, another good quote from Vern is, "Oh God, that's weird. What the hell is Goofy?"
Yeah. What the hell is Goofy? He wears a hat and drives a car. He can't be a dog.
And then there was one where they were talking about their one food for the rest of their life, and he says something like Pez.
Oh, right. Cherry Pez. Cherry flavored Pez. Easy. Cherry flavored Pez.
Oh. I'm trying to think of other good Vern quotes. And there's so many of them, though.
Yeah, there are. He's got a lot of good stuff. I'm trying to remember what he called it when they got 4. They had to flip for Gordy to go to the to go get the food.
Right.
And they flip a coin and they get 4 tails in a row. And he calls it something, like some bad luck term, and I cannot remember.
Oh, I don't remember that either.
Oh, it's like schnookered or something like that. dang it, that's going to drive me nuts. I can't remember what town it's in, and I can't remember the term that he used. So, oh, man. Anyway, that's the importance of Jerry O'Connell bringing it to Stand By Me. I think we definitely had to address it. We couldn't leave him out of the picture, that's for sure.
Yeah, no, we couldn't do a Stand By Me you know, series for our icon without including him. And unfortunately, really kind of the, you know, what we have a lot to talk about because, you know, while we both love that movie, you know, but other than that, he really didn't give us a lot to talk about in the '80s. Plenty of stuff to talk after the '80s, and you know, like I said, my, you know, I gotta love him as Trip McNeely. So,
yeah,
yep. So I think that kind of really wraps up the discussion on Jerry. Then, I almost feel like we also did our final thoughts all at the same time too, didn't we?
I think so.
Yeah,
I think so. Only because he didn't have as much to contribute in the '80s until later on, and you know, until he got past the '80s. So,
right.
I think we can pretty much call that one wraps for now.
All right. So, social media. How can people find you?
You can find me at Scott's Eye on Twitter, or at 80's Auto Reverse on Twitter, or on the Facebook page of 80's Mixtape Auto Reverse.
Cool. I'm Dave. Take care of our 80s Reboot accounts, and that's at 80s Reboot on Twitter, and we're on Facebook, which is facebook.com/80sreboot, 80sreboot.tumblr.com. We also have a blog, which is southgatemediagroup.com/80sreboot blog. And another great way to reach out to us and have some interaction is email. And that's 80sreboot@gmail.com. And then something else that I just wanted to highlight is we're actually doing a crossover event with our blog with several other blogs that are 80s blogs. And we're going to be talking about our favorite 80s cars. So like from TVs, movies. So that's going to be something that's going to be coming up later on in the, or actually mid-November. So look forward to that event, and we're going to definitely have that kind of promotion going out on our social media feeds. Other thing that's very important is getting onto iTunes, giving us a rating and review at 80s Reboot Overdrive. So with all of that, we really appreciate everybody listening and relive in the 80s with us. So have a good night.
Good night.
Night. We hope you've enjoyed this show. This podcast is part of the 80s Reboot Overdrive channel on Southgate Media Group. You can follow us on Facebook on the 80s Reboot group page. We're also on Twitter and Tumblr at 80s Reboot. We invite you to check out all the wonderful podcasts and blogs available at southgatemediagroup.com. And thank you for reliving the 80s. All right. We definitely expanded his talking about Stand By Me on that one.
Yeah, we had to, though.
excuse me.
Are you okay? Are you getting a tickle in your throat? Do you need to get some water?
No, or fine. I'm fine.
Or some scotch?
Actually, I just had some scotch, and that was the first scotch I've had since I've been sick.
Oh, wow.
Well, it's like one of those things where I, like, nothing sounded good. Like, you know, I was like, I wasn't eating, and liquor was like not even in the equation, you know, to even no desire.
Wow, you really were sick.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So this is my, you know, I had my first beer in a while last night, and this is my first scotch tonight.
Well, you know, I almost felt like I had to have some whiskey next to me while we're doing the podcast. It's
kind part of the, it.
Yeah, it kind of goes so well with it, you know?
Yeah.
Do you want to do River Phoenix, or do you want to cut it off for the night?
I don't know. I think I can cut it off.
All right.
Because I need an episode for Tuesday, which this will fill that.
Okay. Hey, I did want to tell you one quick thing before we go. Our conversation the other day about the computer games.
Yeah.
Totally inspired me to like write a blog. I wrote I like opened up Word document and I just started spewing, you know.
Nice.
So I don't know where it's going to go yet. It's really long-winded. I haven't even finished it. And I might have to listen to our recording again to re-trigger some of that those juices again. But it really inspired me to go back and think about all the stuff that I did with those computer games at the time. And you know, I touched base on quite a few different computer games, mostly Wizardry at the time, but other stuff like, you know, Castle Wolfenstein, and there's one called Choplifter. I don't know if you ever had Choplifter. That was a great game. Very simple.
Is that the one where you had to like rescue people and take them over?
Yes.
Right.
You had a helicopter.
Right. Right.
And you had to fly down and pick up so many people and bring them back and drop them off in a safe area.
Right.
And then go back out and try to pick them up. And it was just as many as you could get. That was the whole thing.
And at the same time, weren't you being shot at? Was that right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Now, wasn't that game also on the Atari?
I don't remember if it was on Atari, but I definitely remember being on Apple IIe. Along with
I know I've played it. I just don't remember if it was Apple or Atari.
How about Karateka?
No, I don't remember that.
Okay, that's a good one too. Yeah, those are good ones.
All right. Well, so. If you're writing it, you know, I mean, when you get it ready, you know, we can definitely post it.
Well, you know, I would want you to proofread it first and make sure I don't make any mistakes, because that's something that drives me nuts. Is even though, you know, the word will pick up misspellings,
right?
But if you use the word and or and twice in a row, it doesn't pick that up usually. Unless it's sometimes they'll see the grammar and they'll try to alert you, but you know, it doesn't always catch it. That's obvious online. You see a lot of mistakes people make. So, I'm going to continue to work on it. I'm probably going to listen to that version or that portion that we recorded about that one night too. Did you ever go back and listen to it at all?
No, I did not.
Okay. I was basically rambling on and on. babbling about wizardry. It's funny. I was like a Dungeons and Dragons geek. But I didn't play Dungeons and Dragons. We'll have to record River Phoenix another time and then get on to Mr. Corey Feldman, which I'm more excited about him than any other previous ones.
Oh, yeah definitely. Corey's going to have a lot. We'll have a lot to talk about with Corey.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely with I mean, he was in The Burbs and, you know.
Well, just tons of things.
Lost Boys.
Lost Boys, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got stuff to talk about with Corey.
Oh, yeah. License to Drive.
Yeah.
Dream a Little Dream.
All right. Yeah, there's another. Wow, you just keep going. All right.
Yep.
All right, man.
All right.
Have a good Sunday night and continue to feel better, buddy.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
All right, later.
Bye. Imagination. This is more than a dream come true. Without the slightest bit of hesitation, I knew what I was meant to do. Sometimes it's done.